Guru Pyo Nama. I am Dr. Ram Sastri, MD Ayurveda from Usmane University, retired professor, PhD department of Gayatrikitsa, Hyderabad. Now I am going to present a paper on skin diseases and their management, an analytical approach. This is more important paper. Nowadays, skin diseases have become more rampant just because of the lifestyle of an individuals. In that case, it has become mandatory for a physician to tackle these conditions in a particular manner. In this particular condition, I am prepared to give some important points with special reference to skin disease and their management, an analytical approach. Now, a group of skin diseases is general and classified as Kusta Roga according to Ayurveda. The definition of Kusta goes like this: Kushaha Nishkarshane, which comes out from the inner part of the body, from the out to the outer part. Nishkarshane also indicates the meaning to excrete out, to deform, and to scrap out. Kushnati Vapuhu is Kushnati. This is more important. The body becomes unpleasant to look at. Kushnati Nisheshena Vilekhanam Karoti Angapratyangani. The condition in which different organs of the body, dhatus and upadhatus, are destroyed. This is more important. Tacham Karoti Vaivarnyam. Discoloration of skin takes place. And thus, this is from Siddhanta Kaumudi, Shabda Kaumudam, saying that the definition of Kusta goes like this in different conditions. Coming to Kusta, the salient features. Kusta is an upasargika roga said by Susrata Sutrasthana. It is one among Mahavyadis said by Ashtanga Sangraha. And once again, this is a viruthaharaja vyadhi, which is deep in nature. It has got its own significant condition. It makes the body totally destructive. In that condition, it is supposed to be visheshena viruddhahara visharada vyadhi. This is from Charakasustrasthana. Saptako dravya sangraha. The causative factors for Kusta, for the manifestation of Kusta, are about 7. This is from Charakachikitsasthana. This is Charakriya. This Charakriya indicates this is very slow in development and requires prolonged line of treatment. These two conditions indicate the Chirakriya, the disease, Kusta. This is from Vijayarakshita commentary on Ashtanga Sangraha. Visheshena Sparsagnanam. When generally in Kustagana, you have the anesthetic patch. This is supposed to be a very good condition described by Charakachikitsasthanam. This is a Raktajakrimija Vyadhi. This Vyadhi is produced by Raktakrimi. The quotation is given by Madhavanidana. Kustam Dirgharoganam Pradhanam. This is a definition given by Dharana Samhita. Kusta is a disease which makes you to suffer for many years. In that way, Dharana has commented on this particular point, saying that he observed that the Kustam Dirgharoganam Pradhanam. It makes you to suffer for many years. In that context, Dharana gave this very particular quotation. Then Kastataro Rogam. This is very difficult to treat. In that context, this particular quotation is being coined. This is also once again from Dalana. Once again, Janmantarapi Tat Anubhavam Darsayati. This is a particular quotation given by Ashtanga Sangraha, saying that this particular disease suffers the gentleman for so many years, even for Janmantaram also. Very good observation by Dalana. Vakshyante, once again, Vakshyante Raktadoshajaha. This is once again Raktadoshajavadi. This makes your body totally destructive by its continuous affection. And finally, this is said to be a Sparishavatam in Rasana Samachayam. This is a very good nomenclature coined by Rasana Samachaya for a disease Kusta. Viruddhaharas. Bahulyano Upayogi Kaditam. This is more important. Most of the Viruddhaharas we generally practice in day-to-day life, they cause Kusta Vyadhi. This Kusta Vyadhi is said to be one among Mahavyadis. Mahavyadhi indicates that is very difficult to treat the cases and very difficult to manage. In that way, this is coined as Mahavyadhi. And this Mahavyadhi once again gives us clue that it suffers the gentleman for so many years besides its treatment. This is more important. The condition of Viruddhaharas is already described. In that condition, Viruddhahara has to be taken into consideration for the development of Kusta Vyadhi. And Kusta Vyadhi is once again a Mahavyadhi. It has to be taken note of. Then, importance of Ahara and its general factors. Ahara, when once you take a physiological ahara and pathological condition and a physiological sense. Physiological sense, aharam शरीरम धार्यते. नंबर टू हिताहार उपयोग एव पुरुष पृथिकरो भवति. थर्ड कोटेशन देहो हि आहार संभव. दिस इज फ्रॉम चरक सूत्र स्थान. इन दट कॉन्टेक्स्ट आहार हैज गॉट ए वेरी गुड रोल इन मेंटेनेंस ऑफ बॉडी. दट अल्टीमेटली व्हेन वंस यू डिवॉइड ऑफ द कंडीशंस इट मेक्स यू टू सफर फ्रॉम कुष्ठ. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. कमिंग टू पैथोलॉजिकल कंडीशंस आहार वैषम्यात अस्वास्थ्यम रोगश्च आहार संभव आहार अहितोहार व्याधि निमित्तानि अप्राप्त काल भोजनम व्याधि निमित्तानि फाइनली अधिक भोजनम हैज गॉट जराकरम. दीज थ्री कंडीशंस आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दीज थ्री आर ऑब्जर्वेशंस बाय सुश्रुत समेत एंड असंग्रहकार. दीज टू अदर्स गेव मच इंपॉर्टेंस फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ महाव्याधीज एंड दिस महाव्याधि कुष्ठ इज सेड टू बी मोर डिस्ट्रक्टिव फॉर द बॉडी. देन कमिंग टू विरुद्धाहार वेगधारणम वेग अधारणम दिवास्वप्नम. दीज थ्री वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉजिटिव फैक्टर्स फॉर कुष्ठ. कमिंग टू मानसिक विकारास भय क्रोध चिंता राग. दीज थ्री आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड वेन वंस यू कम अक्रॉस द कोटेशन गिवन बाय अष्टांग हृदय वेरी फर्स्ट श्लोक इट सेल्फ सेज रागादि रोगान. राग इट सेल्फ इज अ रोग. इन दट कॉन्टेक्स्ट रियली ऑब्जर्वेशन मेड बाय अष्टांग संग्रहकार संग वाग्भटकार सेइंग दट दिस पर्टिकुलर कोटेशन हैज गॉट वेरी गुड इंपॉर्टेंस इन द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ डिसीज. राग इट सेल्फ इज अ रोग. इट वॉज आइडेंटिफिकेशन मेड बाय हिम एंड रियली इट्स अ वेरी गुड ऑब्जर्वेशन बाय हिम. देन कमिंग टू इडियोपैथिक कॉजेस पापम कर्म च कुर्वताम. दिस पापम कर्म च कुर्वताम इज अ वेरी गुड डायरेक्शन गिवन बाय अवर आचार्य सेइंग दैट दिस पापम कर्म च कुर्वताम कम्स अंडर प्रज्ञापराधम. इवन इफ यू नो वेरी गुड थिंग्स नॉट टू बी ऑफ कोर्स इवन इफ यू गो गुड थिंग्स दीज डिसीजंस व्हेन वंस यू प्रैक्टिस इट्स सपोज्ड टू बी डेफिनेटली अ गुड थिंग. व्हेन वंस यू सिंपली इग्नोर and you practice in a negative fashion that comes under prajnaparadha. And once again papakriya in the present days and purakruta karma is past days. So whatever karma you do particularly practice in the present day or in the earlier days that may lead to kushta vyadhi. And this is more important. Papa means according to the dictionary bad, vicious, crime, guilt, wrongdoing. So all these things may come to a conclusion saying that these things may ultimately result in a manner of kushta in a body which is supposed to be a vibrant disease. Then coming to samprapti kushtotpadaka dravya sangraham saptani. So kushtotpadaka dravya sangraham are about 7 all the 7 3 plus 4. This is from charaka samhita saying that the time taken for samprapti of kushta is too long. And recognizing these various stages, it takes its own course of time to recognize the disease kushta and to manage the disease kushta. This type of application is more important as far as samprapti is concerned. So coming to pururupa, mainly belonging to the skin, pururupas are structure of the skin, color of the skin, sweating and sensation. These four are very important factors to be taken into consideration for a pururupa of a kushta. So that at the level of pururupa only, when once a physician tries to treat the disease, this will be more easy and you can totally treat the disease in a comfortable fashion. When once you ignore it or a patient ignores the condition, it is ultimately a difficulty problem. But both physician and patient to tackle the problem, to make it cured, this is more important and one must take a note of it. This is absolutely essential for a physician to treat, for a patient to get rid of the disease. Then coming to varieties. Mahakushtas are 7, Kshudrakushtas are 11. For signs and symptoms, these are all very important and every disease is discussed in different conditions. When once you take Kushta as a whole, though on the whole, the points are to be considered here. The point noted to be here, the names of Kushtas appear to be not totally based on doshas. They are all once again, as I said earlier, this is once again papakarma and other areas. Can be taken into consideration. Then sadhya sajita tvak raktamamsajam is sadhyam medojam yapyam asti majjagatam and with upadravas is asajyam. This is more important. And that condition, since it is disease said to be out of papa karma, the important factor in a physician is, a physician should have Amrita Hasta. Amrita Hasta in sense, his Hasta should be equivalent to Amrita. There is a reference in Ashtanga Sangraha about Amrita Hasta of a physician is, this is, Amrita Hasta quotation goes like this, Anamadhastarekankaha, Tasyat Amrita Hastavan Bhavati. When once you find a straight line below the ring finger, his Hasta is supposed to be Amrita Hasta. When once a medicine is given with that Amrita Hasta, gentlemen, naturally it works. So in that context, I personally feel that a physician should himself dispense the medicine, but not allow the any other gentleman to dispense the medicine by means of a compounder and so on and so forth. In that way, my dear friends, a physician should dispense the medicine only with his own hands, and you should consider his own hand as Amrita Hasta, then disease can be easily managed, and you should try to manage the conditions very easily. So that is supposed to be Amrita Hasta reference. This is from Prasanna Samuchayam, second volume. This is more important. And second condition is chikitsa confining to samana, as far as kusta is concerned, nidana parivarjanam is more important. This is a common factor for all diseases. This is also once again stipulated here, saying that you should be devoiding of nidanam as far as disease kusta is concerned. Second point, vrittaharas are not to be taken. This being sankramik roga, avoid close contact with the patient. Kusta is a sankramik roga, so that you are not supposed to have continuous contact with the patient. You should be, you should devoid of the patient. That's more important. Then coming to charakriya, this being slow in development and it requires prolonged line of treatment, results expected are also slow. So in that context, it is named as charakriya. This is a very good observation made by them. Then yapya, asajja varieties are also to be taken for treatment to prevent complications. This is more important. When once you leave the patient without treating, considering only yapya and asajja, it's not wise on the part of a physician to leave the patient without treatment. So it is wise on the patient, wise on the part of a physician to treat the case, to tackle the case based upon the condition and the requirement of the treatment. This is more important. This is to prevent complications of a disease, kusta karma. Then treatment should be started from Purrupa stage only. Then it is very easy for a physician to get rid of the, physician to tackle the disease, and the patient for get rid of this condition. This is more important. Since it is psychosomatic disease, Kustagna along with Major Dravyas are more important. This is a very unique observation made by Acharya, saying that Kustagna Dravya should have not only Kustagna property, it should also have Major property. In that way, Major has got a wonderful role. At the same time, Kusta, the seat of Kusta Vyadhi is once again Tvak. Tvak is supposed to be Upadhatu of Rasadhatu. In that case, Rasayana Dravya also has got major role in the management of Kustagna, since Tvak is Upadhatu of Rasa. And once again, since it is a psychosomatic disease, the major part to be considered here is Major Rasayana, Kustagna, once again Rasayana. When once a drug which possesses all the three qualities, and my dear friends, it will have a definite impact on the disease, Kustagna. This works wonderfully when these three things are considered along with treatment. Besides Kustagna, major rasayana dravyas are to be considered for better results. Major rasayanas like Brahmi, Amalaki should also be considered here. They give definitely a wonderful relief. This has to be taken note of. Chikitsa. Chikitsa, you can classify chikitsa into three levels. Antaparimarjanam, Vaiparimarjanam. Antaparimarjanam with three types of treatments. One is herbal, another is mineral, another is herbomineral. So you come across these preparations in day-to-day practice. Herbal drugs, mineral drugs, herbomineral with compound preparations, both herbals and minerals. So these combinations, they prove definitely effective. And these preparations are to be taken based upon the condition of the treatment once again, condition of the patient once again, whether herbal, mineral, herbomineral are to be selected. These things are based upon, once again, the doctor's choice. This is more important. Coming to Vaiparimarjanam, the Aragvadam is Srestam. Aragvada Kashayam is supposed to be taken for external application. It is a wonderful approach made by our Acharyas. Aragvada Kashayam is a very good preparation for Vaiparimarjanam. This is more important. Coming to Kustagna Dravyas, Here, I have taken a note from the textbook of Baba Prakasa. I have screened the whole textbook of Baba Prakasa Nigantu, right from first page to last page. That screening helped me to come across around 110 drugs to possess Pushtavana property. This is a very good observation made by our acharyas, and of course this is a unique approach made by the author. And Baba Prakasa Nigantu was screened. Once you have screened the whole Nigantu, I came across around 110 drugs which possesses Kustagana property. Out of all Kustagana property drugs, Kustagana, Kustahara, Rasayana, Dravyals, which are from herbal source, I am going to here right now give you. One is Guduchi, second is Kapikachu, three Bhrangaraja, fourth Bakuchi, five Vamsalochana, six Erandataila. This is more important, as I was already earlier discussed in Kashyapa Samhita, and Laksha, Viseshat, Vyanganasanam. Laksha is a very good drug to get rid of Vyangam, and to treat Vyanga is very difficult because this is more common in females. This Vyanga condition is generally seen in postmenopausal conditions. It's a wonderful treatment given by our Baba Prakashakara, saying that Laksha is a very good drug for extended application, and this has to be taken into consideration. And Kustahara, Rasayana, Mechitravyas, herbals, Haritaki, Amalaki, Nirgundi, Pippali, Lasuna, Shankapushpi, Guggulu, Mandukaparani. Mandukaparani especially, its swarasam is more important, Bhallatakam, Gomutram. And there is an observation once again by Chopra in his textbook of medicinal plants, saying that it contains ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid is once again a very good skin protector. In that way, Mandukaparani, as a major rasayana and as a kustagana, it has got a wonderful role in maintaining most of the skin diseases, and it's a wonderful drug to be taken into consideration. Once again, a kakamachi, a drug of choice as a sajja rasayana. Kakamachi is medhyam, rasayanam, kustaganam. In that context, it is sajja rasayana. This is from Ashtanga Sangraham. It's a very good drug to be taken into consideration, more important. Then, Kustagna, Rasayana, Methya, minerals. Since I have already discussed about herbal drugs, let us come to the drugs, minerals. One drug is Swarna, Loha, Tamra, Chilajit, Swarnamakshika, Parada, Gandhaka, Abraka, Kasisa, Rasasindura, Loha as Ajrasayana, Talakam, Sarvarakta Vikaranam, Talakam Paramoshadam. It's a wonderful observation made by our acharyas in Rastarangani. It's a wonderful direction for a physician from the textbook of Ayurveda, saying that Sarvarakta Vikaranam Talakam Paramoshadam. In all Rakta Vikara diseases, Talakam is said to be a very effective drug, and you should take into consideration, this is a very good drug. One should prepare Talakavasma by himself based on the textbook references, so that since Talaka being once again a powerful preparation, you should have your own preparation so that you will have confidence over the drug, and Talaka should be prepared by yourself, and you are supposed to dispense with the medicine. That's more important. This is a direction given by Rastantra Sahara Sangra. Very good preparation. Coming to Shubhra, Sarva Kustaharam Viseshat. This is, there is a reference by elderly people with their experience, saying that this is medhyam, once again Atikopyam. A wonderful observation I received from the elderly gentleman, saying that this is medhyam, once again Atigopyam. Since it is Atigopyam, it is not supposed to be leaked out, but still, in the interest of the community, in the interest of the humanity, this reference was given. This is really a very effective drug. Suprabhasam, very easily available drug, non-controversial, non-toxic. This can be easily taken for practice. There is major rasayana and kustagana rasayana. It's a very, very important drug to be taken. And it's very easy for a physician to collect and to practice. This is important. Then coming to compound preparations, Jantughna Vati is a very good preparation from Rasa Samachayam. Kustha Jantu Nihati Asu. It immediately relieves the disease. Kustha Jantu, in the sense, this Krimine, Hanti Nihanti Asu, immediately the more important. Svitrahara Prayoga, this is a very good drug in Svitram. Kaishavar Gugulu, Jayet Sarvani Kustani, a wonderful preparation by Sarangadhara Samhita. It treats most of the Sarvani Kustani. It treats all the diseases, especially with separate reference to Kusta and this is once again said earlier, nityam upayukto rasayanam. This is rasayana drug, it is meant to maintain the healthiness of the individual and to treat the disease. Jayen sarvani kustani is once again a direction by Sarandara Samhita. Very good drug, very easily available drug, cost effective drug, very important drug. Coming to Narasimha Krutam, Harati Ashtadha Kustani. This is from Sahasra Yogam. Ashtadha Kustani in the sense, Ashtadasa Kustani. All 18 Kustas can be successfully treated with this drug by Narasimha Churnam. Since it is a herbal drug, you can continuously give for some number of years also, this can be given. It's a very good drug, direction by Sahasra Yoga. Coming to Yoshadi Vati, Tvak Vikaranam Hanti. This is from Yoga Ratnakaram. Generally, Vyoshadivati, we practice in Kasa Svasa, and this is a very good observation made by Yoga Ratnakara, saying that it's a very good effective medicine in Tvak Vikaranam Hanti. Hanti in the sense it destructs, it totally destructs. In that context, Vyoshadivati also is a very good drug of choice in the management of skin diseases like Kusta. There is one preparation by name Langali Guti. This is from Gadanigraha. Sarvani Kustani Jayati Ati Balanapi. Even most of the Kustas, they are all highly aggressive in nature, can also be treated with this particular drug called Langali Gutika, Gadanigraha Yogam, very effective yoga. Sarvani Kustani Jayat Api Balanapi. Then coming to Pippali Yogam, Lidhyam Sarvani Kustani Upahanti. Lidhya, when once you take it by means of Lidhyam, it diminishes all the Kustas. More important, this is from Chakradatta, very good preparation made by him. And Rajatamula, Rajataromula Churnam. Rajataromula Churnam, Pibet Masadvayam Kustaharam. Once you take this for about 2 months, Kusta can be successfully treated. This is from Rasa Samachayam. These are all compound preparations beside routine drugs. All these drugs are very effective, cost effective once again. You can immediately get some positive results, and you should be in a position to prepare them with your own pharmacy, then it is successful. And it's not wise to depend on others for its preparation. That's important. Coming to compound preparations continuation, Amruta Ghrutam Kustam Jayati Sudharanam. Even if it is aggressive in nature, Kustam Jayati, this is from Sarangadara Samhita, name of the drug is Amruta Ghrutam. Then coming to Sri Bahusalagudam, Major Asayanam Uttamam Sarvam Rogam Nihati Asu. This is once again a major asayana and kustaganam. In that context, my dear friends, Bahusalagudam is a drug of choice in Kusta, since it possesses rasayana property. This is from Gadanigraham. Then coming to Pachavatakam, Asesha Kustam Mahanihanti. This is more important. Most of the Kustas are aggressive in nature. Even that aggressiveness can be managed with Pachavatakam. This is from Gadanigraham. Coming to Brahmi Vati with Swarna Sindhura. Brahmi Vati without Sindhu, Swarna Sindhura is also available, but Brahmi with Swarna Sindhura is highly effective in this context, saying that Kustahara major rasayana. Since I was discussing earlier, this particular Brahmi Vati with Swarna Sindhura possesses all the three compounds, possesses all the three qualities like Kustahara, Medhya, and Rasayana. So when once this drug possesses all the three qualities, this is very easy for a physician to tackle the case with one single preparation, taking into consideration all the three properties. Then it's very easy for a physician to tackle. Then Suta Sindhuram, this is Shanmasika Prayogena Deya Suddhim Prayojati. If it gives you for 6 to 7 months, this Kustan Aseshat Thandi, this brings Kustan into definitely under control. This is from Vajichintamani, a very good yogam. Then Ekaguna Sindhuram, this is Apaharati Roga Vrundam. Roga Vrundam in the sense is a syndrome, disease syndrome of a particular Kustagna, Kusta disease can be totally managed with Ekaguna Sindhura. This is Drudayati Kayam. This makes body totally effective, totally Balavan conditions. Then Mahat Balam Kurute Sukrasya. This is a wonderful drug for Sukradhatu also. Ekaguna Sindhura has a herbal mineral preparation, can be taken as a very good drug. Rasantrasara Sangras, Chitaprayo Sangra. Then coming to Bhai Paramajanam, Haritaki Palachurnam with Tilatailam. Purana Kustaha Varanapaha. This is a wonderful wound healing drug, a wonderful drug to be taken. Haritaki Palachurnam with Tilatailam. This is from Rasan Samachayam. very, very effective preparation, and this can be practiced successfully. Rajataro Mola Churnam is once again Aragvathamolam. Rajataro in this sense, Aragvathamolam, Masabdayam, Vilayapath, Kustaharam. When once you apply it externally for 2 months, this is a very good drug for management of Kusta. And once again, since it is a Papakarma Jakurutam, Dhavyapasa Chikitsa is more important because there are some particular conditions saying that Dhavyapasa Chikitsa has got a major role, especially in Kusta, because the causative factor for Kusta is said to be once again a Papakarma. In that context, the necessity of Dhavyapasa Chikitsa has got its major role. Then a doctor should advise the patient to go for Dhavyapasa Chikitsa. This is Divasa, that is Divasanatha Chupujam. Divasanatha Puja. In this Divasanatha, in the sense, Divasanatha is Surya. This is Surya Upasana is more important. When Surya Upasana is totally objected and you dictate the terms about Surya Upasana, mostly the disease may come into control. This is once again a very good effective source to treat Kusta based on Dhavyapasa Chikitsa, based upon its causative factor as Papa. Then points in treatment is, you come across a different nomenclature with different modalities of drug actions seen in textbooks of Ayurveda. A physician and a student, they should be very well versed with these terms, and they should pay much attention while reading the textbook of Ayurveda for its clinical effect. This is more important. These are all very important conditions to be taken note of, and I once again give these conditions from the textbooks of Ayurveda. This is, as far as treatment of Kusta is concerned, you come across this nomenclature, which is Kusta Haram, Kusta Nasham, Kusta Nut, Kusta Jit, Kustam Hanti, Hanti Sudharanam, Nivarete, Kshayam, Shantikrut, Durjayam Hanti, Prasamani, Vinashanam, Jayet. These are all the, specific usages, especially in the management of diseases. These are all got very good importance to treat cases. Likewise, Kustam Kustaharam, Kusta Nasam, Kusta Nut, Kusta Jit, Kustam Hanti, Kusta Sudharanam, Kustam Nivarayet, Kusta Kshayam, Kusta Shantikrut, Kustam Durjayam Hanti, Kustam Prasamani, Kustam Vinasanam, Kustam Jayet. All this terminology, nomenclature, you come across in the textbooks of Ayurveda, and these nomenclature, you can make use of them based on the condition, because this nomenclature has got a specific role based on the therapeutic values of the drug. In that context, my dear friends, the thing is, you should be in a position to select the drug based on the nomenclature. Then, this nomenclature is useful for a physician to select the drug in a preparation. That's more important. In that context, this nomenclature is very important for a physician to follow. These terms are to be given much importance in day-to-day practice to achieve very good results. These are all very important conditions to put down. Then Ahara Dravyas as Pachya. Takram, Nati Dravam, Nati Sandram. Takram, when once you call it Takram, it is Padajalam, as Ardhajalam or Padajalam. Takra can be taken in two contexts. One is Ardhajalam and there is Padajalam. This is from Bhavaprakasha. And Takratak Dravaga Napravanti, this is once again a very important quotation. Coming to Matsyakshi, Kustajit, this is Ahara Dravya. This can be taken regularly in your day-to-day food, this is more important. Coming to Jirakam, Durgandhyanasanam, in most of the conditions of Kusta, your body becomes a specific condition by giving a bad order. So that specific bad order can be removed by means of applying Jirakadravyam. Jirakam, both internally and externally, this is from Sushil Sutrasthanam. Coming to Gudam, besides its rasayana property, it has got Raktasodhanam. Raktasodhana drug definitely gives very good important result to Kusta. In that context, Guda also can be successfully given the Ahara Dravya in Pachya. Coming to Ahara Dravya's Apachyas, Amla Dadi Rakta Pradushanam. Krishnam Raktam Vidahati. This is more important point. Amla Dadi is not to be taken for a patient suffering from Kusta. That ultimately makes Rakta to be totally destructed, totally affected. In that context, Amla Dadi should be avoided. Then Madhyam, Asrik Pradushanam. Madhyam is not supposed to be taken internally, and that context, Asrik Pradushanam to be taken a note of it. Then Thailapakka Bhakshyam is Tvak Pradushanam. More important, Thailapakka Bhakshyas are to be avoided here. This is from Sushruta Sutrasthanam. Very good observation made by him. So direction from Apta is Yathopadesmayo Prayogo Nayataraha. So they give you direction saying that what all Aptas say, this is your primary duty to follow their directions without any question, so that you have positive results, and these results you have very good results in your day-to-day practice. And in that context, Kusta being a Mahavyadhi, it should be tackled in a particular time, in a particular season, by particular medicine, by preparing medicine with his own, and this is more important. Once again, the stress to be made, stress has to be given to the preparation by selecting based upon the nomenclature and based upon the severity of the condition and based upon the general conditions of the patient. And this is more important. One should take note of all these conditions. Coming to conclusion, the disease Kusta in toto was thoroughly studied by our acharyas, observed and understood to a greater extent by our acharyas of Ayurveda in our older days. Then the management of some of the important diseases like Kusta is essential in the present day practice with rasayana drugs. Hopefully in near future, the disease like Kusta can be easily managed with the lifestyle modifications, which indeed essential. So this is more important for a physician to tackle the disease in a specific condition, taking into consideration of all the etiological factors, samprapti and the sajara sajata, and finally for treatment. The treatment should be successfully managed with all the other supplementations like ahara and vihara. Then we are very sure that we can certainly treat the disease in a hopeful fashion. Thank you.